Okay. Well, I decided to pick up a passenger mission. Not that one. There we go. Holy Twins. I did have a bit of a mishap leaving the home station. Missed the mail slot. Hit the station. Instant 50% hull. So, yeah, kind of kicking myself for that. So now I can't get scanned or hit anything. Or I lose the mission, essentially. Pays out about 15 million credits, which is pretty good. But it's a 12,000 light year journey, and I've made it pretty far. I'm only 10 jumps away from it now. Traveled quite a distance. So I'm hoping to make quite a bit in the exploration data. Let's see. So as you can see, I traveled from way over here, Epsilon Eridani, over to, I'm on my way here. It's another 135 light years, which isn't bad. That's just for the one point. And then I have to plot another course closer to there, and then basically 1,000 light years at a time. So I'm gonna have to set my journey 12 times to get there. So that'll be fun. So yeah, what's in this station? System? Nothing. Okay.
Frameshift drive charging.
On to the next star. Swapped out my shield generator for an extra fuel tank so I have more range. Well, less range on the jumps, more range if I encounter a pocket of unscoopable stars. Obviously, my business class passenger compartment, fuel scoop, those are all the size 4s. But I'm getting this whole thing down. Jump in, scan. Ooh, 33. We'll have to see what that is all. It's probably like 2 stars and 7 giants with rings and moons.
Fuel scoop disengaged.
Or just one really big solar system. 3,000 light seconds. Like, I'm not sure if it picks it up, but like planets like this, it looks like it's blue with a bit of red tint. Oh, there's a good one. But yep, there's that one. That's not what I wanted. That one looks pretty.
Frameshift drive charging.
On to the next one. There have already been claimed. 9 jumps. Jumping screen is always so pretty. You gotta love the loading screens.
Fuel scooping.
One other thing, so probably another star. Yeah, it's not just another star. Off to the next one.
Frameshift drive charging.
I know I could probably take the Neutron Star Highway all the way out, since it's way out by Colonia, but I don't know, I'm thinking just do the jumps. Maybe I'll eventually hop on the highway if I'm close enough to it.
Fuel scoop disengaged.
Do a few jumps that way. Oh, look. Trinary star, or not star planets. Nothing of note.
Frameshift drive charging.
Actually, where is... there we go.
Fuel scooping complete.
There we go. I don't think there is any. Oh well.
Frameshift drive charging.
Oh, whoops.
Fuel scoop disengaged.
Yes, gotta love the ice on the windshield, right? Alright, now I'm good.
Drive charging.
This is probably the worst content to watch, since it's quite literally just jump after jump after jump. I'm probably gonna have hundreds of these.
Frameshift drive charging.
After a couple of hundred of these, you get really good at them. So. It's good practice, I suppose. It beats docking in an orbital. But I don't really like docking in the orbital. The mail slot is, I don't know, it's tight going in and out. It's, well, it just sounded wrong. But yeah, there's not much room. It's so easy to hit the sides and damage your hull out and get your passengers mad at you. Yeah, I'll delete these. No, it's not what I wanted.
Fuel scooping.
Anything interesting?
Fuel scoop disengaged.
Not really. Some nice purple planets. But not really.
Frameshift drive charging.
I already did that. You know what I should have done is pick up the thing for the Colonia migration, help that out, since I'll be basically in the area. Would have been nice. Last time star, that's a scoopable one. I'm good. Well, 12 and a half minutes of this is probably all that you really need. Not really need. But that's really all I want to record. Probably start picking it back up once I reach the destination and fully explore that solar system. But we'll see how that goes. Until next time, see you later.